channel. So today, since so many of you guys loved the vanity mirror that I built, see the marble floor down there? Dun, dun, dun. Guess what? I actually did that too. So I thought it'd be fun to show you guys today how I did it, because believe it or not, it was even cheaper than making the vanity mirror and even easier. So here we go. Throw on your construction hats, ladies. We are getting down and dirty. Sort of.
All right, so we are going to start our journey at Lowe's, because that is where I bought everything. So here we go. All right, so once you're inside, you want to head over to the flooring section, because that is where we're going to pick up our tiles.
Okay, so now what you're actually going to be looking for is something called groutable vinyl, which is vinyl flooring. It's not real marble, which is why it's so cheap and why you can install it yourself and you don't need professionals. So this is what it looks like.
So as you can see, it looks exactly like real stone and stuff, but check it out. The price is literally $1.28. So this is my jam.
Now these will come in boxes like this. How many are in here? Probably a bajillion of them. You don't need this many. Depending on how large of an area you're doing, you can just buy them one by one. So feel free to open the box like I just did.
I'm like the customer from hell.
No, you really are allowed to open the box, I promise you. So you can check it out. This is the ones that I personally bought last time I was here. As you can see, it's just a piece of vinyl looking marble thing with some sticky. You can pull the back off and it's sticky underneath, which is how it will stick to your floor. So there you go, pick out as many as you need. They're 1 foot by 1 foot, so you decide how many you think would need your room. More is always better, because like I said, they're a buck, so you might as well get a few extra. All right, so the next thing you need is you're also gonna want to buy some like intense, what it looks like you would like murder someone with. That was super vulgar. Anyways, no. Basically just a really heavy duty scissor that will cut through the tile if need be. So grab a pair of those, they're about $9. All right, second place you gotta go, just a generic CVS or a Joann's. All you need is a couple of craft supplies. So all we need from here is a piece of white poster board. This is 99 cents. And the other thing you're gonna need is some duct tape that matches the color of your wall. My walls happen to be white, so we are going to go with white. Alrighty, now that we're back from our shopping trip, time to get started. You don't actually need a hammer, I just wanted to look official. No, not on my nice camera. Okay, anyways, here we go. Alrighty, so this is what it looks like with nothing. Ta-da! This was just a little nook and cranny in my apartment where I had originally built the vanity mirror, but I was like, you know what, this just doesn't look as luxurious as it should, so I'm gonna do something else, and I thought marble flooring would do the trick. And guess what? I was right. All right, now since I've already done this part, I will just do a little extra section over here to show you for showcase purposes. But all you wanna do is, now since this is an apartment, which is why I'm gonna do this first, if you don't have an apartment and you're allowed to put whatever you want to on the floors, you don't need to do this step, but since it is an apartment, I'm going to lay this poster board down, because that is what will protect, here, we'll do it over here. That is what will protect the floor from when you put the vinyl down on it, it's sticky. So you don't really want it sticking to whatever floor the apartment has, so that's why I put this poster down, so it'll be sticking to that instead, which is also what makes it so easily removable. Then you wanna take the tile. Now, as you can see on the back is what's just like paper, and the back of this is sticky, so like you can't really see, but it's sticky, I promise you. So you'll want to take the paper off of that like so, just peel it right off. Doesn't have to be perfect or anything. And then you will decide where you want to put the tile. I'm going to put it in the corner because that makes the most sense, and line it up with that and put it there. The end. So then all you have to do is literally repeat the process, peel the sticky off, line up another piece of tile, plunk it down. And look at that. It looks great. The only other thing you really need to know is, this is why I told you to buy the scissors, is in case you run into an area where it's like this, like you can kind of see in the corner there, I had to cut, oh, ignore the trash on my floor. I had to cut one of the tiles because it wouldn't all the way fit. That's why you buy the scissors, so you can cut right through the tile. It's really flimsy, actually. You could honestly break it if you wanted to with your hands, but the scissors give you a nice straight edge, and you can cut it so it fits into the little areas, just like that.
So now, obviously you would tile the rest of it. I actually didn't buy enough tiles because I only bought enough for that originally. But anywhoosie, the third and final step is where the duct tape comes in. I know this isn't the most professional thing in the world, but since mine is used for pictures only, you can't really see it in real life either. As you can see, this looks a little weird to me just because I'm a perfectionist. I don't like this brown thing. So I lay duct tape over it so it blends in. So you'll just tear off a piece of duct tape that's the appropriate length and literally just lay it down to cover the wood. So you can see it before right here. And then you can see it after with the duct tape. As you can see, I'm not a professional. No one trained me on how to do DIY projects, but this, in my personal opinion, looks way better than the brown. So it's an optional step, but I suggest it. And there you have it, you guys. This is how I built my marble floor, and literally all you have to do is pull up the tape. If you wanna get rid of it, pull up the tape and you can lift the whole thing literally right off the floor. So that is how I installed my marble floors. Hell yeah, that is luxury for an apartment in Los Angeles anyway. And there you have it, you guys. That is how I installed my very own marble floors. It just looks so good. I love it. What a great idea this whole selfie station was. people made fun of me for building it, and then lo and behold, they always come over, and where do we take pictures? Right here. But it doesn't matter. Just low-key shading my friends there a little bit. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions about this, I'd be happy to answer them. So hit me up in the comment section below, or feel free to message me on any of my social media. It's all at Amber Scholl. That is where you can see stunning photography of this whole little scenario on my Instagram every day. But anyways, I guess till next time, enjoy being Bob the Builder, and I will see you very soon. Kisses till next time, you guys. XO. Like, doesn't this just make you feel like luxuriating around your mansion? Huh? Like, oh yes, this is so luxurious looking.
Darling, if you need me, I'll be upstairs plotting the murder of my fourth husband.